Hello students, last lecture we spoke about how to balance an equation and I told you the different steps you know that can be used to balance the equation, both the sides, left hand side and the right hand side. I talk about you know the reactants, the figures, the formulas which are the compounds, elements, maybe the atoms which are written on the left hand side, they are called as reactant or the substrate, and those which are written after the arrow which is called as you know product. So the reactant, they react together, one which reacts is reactant, and what you get in the end is the product. So we have taken you know the few examples to balance the equation. You try to practice little more and come to know the many you know other equations. The last you know equation that we have you know the balance was the iron, and you know which is reacting with the water, that you see the rusting part. Now the ferric oxide is going to be produced and the hydrogen is going to be released in the process. So last step of balancing any equation that requires you know the physical state. I told you there will be four physical state. There can be solid, there can be liquid, there can be gases, or there can be aqueous. So these are the four different, you know, states that could happen, you know, while writing an equation. So once you balance the equation, so that is how I am going to write the equation. Again, I repeat what I told you in the previous lectures, was that you know how different kind, like you know what you have done, you know, you clean a magnesium ribbon. And you burn it to get you know white dazzling appearance, and the ash you collect on the watch glass. Use you know the lead nitrate. Use like you know the many other thing to get a product, right? So today we'll talk about the what is the reaction and what types of the reaction that we have so far. Okay, so let's first talk about the chemical reaction. So there are the four different kind of you know the chemical reaction that we have. One is a combination, another one is the decomposition, third one is the displacement, and fourth one is the double displacement. And in the end we discuss you know the oxidation and the reduction step. Okay, let's first discuss with the combination reaction. During the combination reaction, name itself suggests combination, that means you combine. You can write in this step. Suppose that the two reactants A and B, after the reaction if it is written with the AB, this means these two gets combined, and such kind of reaction we call it as a combination reaction. Okay, so there were two reactants were here, A and B, they react together to give you the AB, and this is the reaction we call as a combination reaction. Okay, let's go into the detail of it. Let's take you know the one example of the you know quick lime. Let's write this equation. You take the calcium oxide, okay, and you react it with the water. What you get it is the calcium hydroxide. Okay, so this is going to be solid, this is going to be liquid, and this is going to be aqueous. Okay, now this is you know it's called as quick lime. This is called as a slag lime. Simple thing, if I tell you in the layman's language, so what we call calcium oxide is a lime chuna. So once you take you know this lime, you know, and add some water, I don't know whether you have done or whether you have seen ever So once you add the water in that, there will be a release of the some effervescence come. Okay, and then calcium hydroxide is going to be formed. Okay, and that is what we use it for the painting and all. Okay, so you can use it for the whitewashing. So what you do while doing a whitewashing, you bring those quick lime from the market. Okay, then as per the coloration, you can add some neem into it or some other color, and then you add the water, mix it well. Sometimes you add the fevicol as well. Again, I'm talking about not talking really about the reaction, and then you paint it, right? So again, what is the reaction happening? Again, I'm excluding the fevicol or the neem out of it. So what you have taken is a quicklime. In the quicklime, which is a calcium oxide, and in that you have added the water molecule. Okay, after adding the water molecule, what happens is that there will be effervescence come. You mix it well, and then you see the aqueous solution of the calcium hydroxide, which could be used, as I told you, for the whitewashing. So what happens is that here the, let's say the calcium oxide was the A, water was the B, and this calcium hydroxide is going to be AB. Okay, so quicklime is the calcium oxide reacting with the water, and what you get in the end is the calcium hydroxide. So A and B reacted together. What it has given you, the AB. That means two reactant here. These two are the reactant or substrate, and this is your product. Fine. So calcium oxide is reacting with the water molecule and giving off the calcium hydroxide. Okay, fine. This is the combination reaction that we have. Fine. Let's take another example. This was the first thing of the example. I hope it is very clear to you. Again, I repeat, you have taken the calcium oxide, that is a quicklime. You added water into it, and as a result, the slag lime is formed, that is a calcium hydroxide, which could be used for the whitewashing. We'll discuss a little more about this little later on. Okay, maybe I can discuss the another part of it. You can see over here. After the whitewashing is done, okay, many times what happens is that this calcium hydroxide react with the available carbon dioxide, and this give the calcium carbonate in the water is going to be released. Again, don't consider this to be the part of the the same reaction, the combination. I'm just talking about little extension of that. So the shiny white color that we see, that is because of the calcium carbonate, and even the marbles, they're made up of calcium carbonate. So this is you don't have to consider this. Let's take the second example. Burning of coal, and we know the coal is a fossil fuel, and then we get it from this fire, the biological material, especially the plants, they are under the tremendous pressure. pressure within the rocks, and that can give rise to the coal or maybe the petroleum product. Okay, so in the end of day, the coal is what it is having the carbon, majority of the cases, and they do have some impurities, right? So let's go, here this is your carbon, which is solid. You burn it, anything that you are burning, that means you are providing it to oxygen, okay? And this will give you the, which is a gas. So once you burn a coal, okay, so what exactly you are burning is the carbon. Again, if we have a different form of the carbon as well, the graphite, the diamond, both are from the carbon. One thing is that there are the different the allotropy that they show. Okay, allotropy means how they are arranged, the kind of the 3D structure they form in the solid structure that give them the particular allotrope. So graphite. All three are made up of carbon. Okay, and since carbon being solid, it reacts with the oxygen, and it is going to give off the CO2, which is the gas. It is called as a complete, burning or the combustion of the coal. Fine. Again, there will be two kind of the combustion here: incomplete and the complete. Incomplete will give you the carbon monoxide, and complete oxidation of the coal will give you the carbon dioxide. But we have to look at in the way, this is your A, this is your B, this is giving you the A. Fine. So this is a kind of the reaction. Similarly, we can write the earlier reaction as well. Mg, 2mg, 2mgO, okay, this is solid, this is gas, okay, this is again the solid, this is the another example that you see, okay, fine. The example number 3 you can consider again, same thing is happening over here, A, B, and this is giving you the AB. This is how it is going to happen. So in the combination reaction, the one or more reactant, they combine together to give you a single product, and such kind of reaction we call it as a combination reaction. That means A plus B is going to give you the A. Okay, let's take the another example. One single product, that reaction we call it as a combination reaction.
decomposition. Decomposition means what? You are having something and to disintegrate. Okay? So you are having a compound that may give off with a different product. Okay? So how this is going to be? This is going to be AB. This is what we call as a decomposition. Just opposite of the combination is the decomposition. Combination means to join, and to separate is the decomposition. Okay? Anything that decomposes means it is disintegrated. It is being separated or it is being degraded. Fine? So let's talk about in terms of reaction. So let's take a very simple reaction. One is that let's talk about the reaction. Some of you already have done. Let's say we'll take one example and we can understand that. So what we do in this reaction is that we take the ferrous sulfate to FeSO4. Okay, how is that? It is going to be solid and you heat it up. Delta sign, this sign stand for heating. So you can heat it. What is happening there is that there will be disintegration. The ferrous sulfate is going to be broken into the sulfur dioxide and the sulfur trioxide. So iron is going to be separated. Fine. It is going to be formed with the So it can give rise to two or more product. Okay, so you can write like this way. You can see the ABC that is going to give you the AB, A plus B plus C. So this is going to be your solid. This is going to be gas. This is going to be sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide. Fine. So this could be known that way. ABC, which is complex, which is a compound, after the heating it is going to give you the Fe2O3, that is a ferric oxide. Okay, and then it is going to give off the sulfur dioxide and the sulfur trioxide, both are going to be gas. Okay, let's talk about the one example that we have discussed earlier in the reverse fashion. What I told you is that we have taken the one example of the calcium carbonate that is formed from the calcium hydroxide and the CO2, they combine together. I told you once why it was. So the atmospheric CO2 will come in the contact with the quicklime to convert into the calcium carbonate. Even the calcium carbonate, all the marbles, they're made up of calcium carbonate. Okay? So calcium carbonate, even you see the shell of the animals, okay, they are also the made up of calcium carbonate. We have seen the shell of many molluscans, they are made up of calcium carbonate. You see the eggshell is also made up of calcium carbonate. So again, how the calcium carbonate organize itself, you can see the marble look different, shell of molluscan they look different, shell of the egg of the birds they look different. That all depends how they are going to organize. Just the same thing I told you about the carbon. It could be gold, it could be graphite, or it could be diamond, but they all not look similar. So how exactly the carbon atom they organize themselves into a 3D structure, that will give you the particular structure. Let's not go into that. Let's take another example. Take the calcium. We'll take another example of the here, that is the made up of calcium carbonate. once you heat it, delta S time you put it for the heating. So what it will give you, the calcium oxide plus CO2. So we write the physical state. So calcium oxide is your, you know, the line, the slag line, okay, and this is the gas. Usually gas we put an arrow, that means this gas is going to be liberated, okay. So what it suggests is that, you know, the same fashion, this is AB, this is A, and this is B, okay. So based on the certain reactions, like, you know, the reaction can be of two types, you know, in terms of energy. It could be exothermic, it could be endothermic. Exothermic means any reaction from where heat is liberated. Called as exothermic in any reaction. For example, if you add water into the calcium oxide, so there will be, you know, the heating process is going to happen. That means it is the exothermic reaction. And once you put glucose into water, it becomes cooler. That means it is the endothermic process. So if the heat is liberated, it is the exothermic, and if the heat is consumed,
or just contrary to it, then the decomposition AB or ABC
they will be broken into the A plus B plus C or A plus B depending upon the reaction. So this is the second type of reaction. Third type of reaction we call it as a displacement. Okay. So what we have done so far, we have done the combination reactions, we have done the decomposition reactions. Let's go into the other reaction that is called as the displacement. So the two more remaining. So let's go to the third one, that is the displacement. A plus B plus C, okay, that is going to give you the AC plus B. That means this C has been displaced, or it has left the B has left and C is going to be shown. Then look at over here, this B has gone separated and C is going to combine here. So AB plus C, that gives you the AC plus B. This is called a displacement. Right? One group is being displaced by the other. Okay? Fine. And similarly, like you know, that you can take many examples in the decomposition as well. Okay? For example, like you know, the silver chloride. If you heat the silver chloride, okay, that is going to be, you know, broken into the silver and the chloride. Similarly, like you know the photochromatic glasses, they contain the silver bromide. So once you wear those glasses, so once you are at home or the cool places or where the light intensity is lesser, they look transparent. But once you go outside, so this AGBR is going to be converted into the AGI. So that is going to be broken into the Ag plus bromide. So that is going to be the colored one. So this is the simple example of the decomposition. Okay. So we have discussed that. Let's go into the another example. Let's discuss the example of the displacement. One reaction I want to write it as. Let's say. You take the iron, we know the iron is going to be solid, okay, that you are going to heat it with the calcium, sulfate. Sorry, it is not a calcium, it's a copper sulfate. And then what you see, ferrous sulfate is going to be formed, okay, plus copper is going to be, released. So here, this is going to be aqueous, this is going to be solid, and here the copper sulfate is going to be, we have used the solution of the copper sulfate, that means going to be aqueous. So what has happened is that, this SO4, if you look at over here, this SO4 has left this and goes to iron. So this is going to, this is iron, this is copper sulfate. This is the